With all of the excitement brewing over the Bruins in the Stanley Cup final, at the same time, a sad day for local hockey fans with the Lewiston MAINEiacs dissolving. After 2 years of financial trouble, the team was sold to the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League last night, ending the team's existence. News 8's Norm Karkos has a closer look and joins us now from our studio. Hi, Norm.
Hi there, Megan, and good evening to you. Hockey, of course, is a business, so bottom line, the Lewiston MAINEiacs were $4 million in debt. So after 8 years, a very sad day for the team, its home arena, and fans alike. So what exactly happened? Why did this happen?
Couldn't pay our bills, very frankly. We haven't been paying our bills on time for quite some time.
It wasn't a matter of if, but when. The Lewiston MAINEiacs had been losing an average of $600,000 for several years. Expenses coupled with the economy all finally adding up.
We need $1.7 million to be able to make a business case, and we haven't reached $1.7 for a long, long, long time.
And that forced the team to use June 1st as basically a decision day. Lewiston Mayor Larry Gilbert was a loyal fan for all 8 years. He thought the team needed to branch out beyond the Twin Cities.
I think they could have gone to Brunswick, where there's a lot of mid-coast youth hockey there, in Augusta, Waterville, and that really didn't happen.
The MAINEiacs were kind of our adopted kids.
There will also be a void for fans like Elaine Mackus. She and her 100-year-old mother were both season ticket holders. She feels previous rumors of the team leaving led to a major drop in attendance this season.
Because people never really quite trusted that they were going to stay. And it's hard to be involved in a relationship if you're wondering if the person's going to walk out the door on you the next moment.
The Androscoggin Bank Colisée underwent millions of dollars in renovations to support the team. Game night would employ up to 65 part-time workers. 50 of them will now be laid off. Between food and beverages, the arena would gross close to $1 million a year. And by the way, those who put down a deposit for season tickets will be reimbursed. I did speak with Jim Kane, the owner of the Colisée, and he says they will now pursue an expansion team from the USHL for the 2012-2013 season, hopefully. In the studio, Norm Karkos, News 8. Megan, back to you.